When evaluating the following, we need to keep several things into consideration. We need to remember that when we do an order of operations problem, we must do parentheses, grouping symbols, and so forth first, and then work from there on. Also, whenever we evaluate the part A on this one, where we're doing the opposite or negative of 6 squared, we have to also remember that with an exponent, you do not apply the exponent to the entire statement unless there are parentheses around it to indicate this. So, for example, if you had parentheses around the entire thing, then you would evaluate the negative and the 6 both to be squared, and your result would come from multiplying the negative 6 repeatedly twice, which two negatives would then give you a positive 36. However, part A, this is not the case. In part A, because there are no parentheses, the square only applies to the 6. So the only thing being squared here is the 6 times 6. The base, in other words, for this problem is 6. The base in this one is negative 6. So you are only squaring 6 times 6, which does give you 36, and then you are applying the opposite or negative to that value. If you have positive 36 and you're doing the opposite, of course the answer then is negative 36. So that negative gets applied after squaring the 6 times 6. So the result for this problem is negative 36. When we do part B, we have the opposite or negative of the absolute value of negative 6. In this case, students make the mistake very often to think two negatives gives you a positive. That's only true in multiplying two negatives together. Here, because absolute value is a grouping symbol with an operation to be worked out, you must work that operation first. If you apply a negative to a negative, that's like a multiplication being done before you do the grouping symbol, which would be out of order. So you must do the absolute value of negative 6 first, which gives you positive 6. Then, again, as the problem was done above, this negative or opposite applies to that. So if it's 6 and you want to do the opposite or negative of that, it becomes negative 6. So our result for this is actually negative 6, not positive 6. Because there is an order to be completed, you must do what's in the grouping symbol first. The absolute value of negative 6 becomes positive 6 initially, and then that negative or opposite applied to the positive 6, making it back into negative. Part C. Now, part C, there are parentheses, so you would treat it kind of like you were above. However, there is nothing to be done inside of this grouping symbol. Parentheses doesn't have a step in this case to be done inside because it's just a negative 6. So negative 6 stays negative 6 here until this opposite or negative applies to it. So the opposite of a negative becomes a positive. Or you can, in this case, say that two negatives gives you a positive because there is no work to be done to make this change. In this example above, the absolute value changed that from a negative into a positive. So you actually did a change there and made it a positive 6. Then the negative applied to that. This one, there is no change here. It's negative 6 stays negative 6 until the other negative is applied to it, changing the negative into a positive. So the result of this one is positive 6. So be very careful when doing absolute values compared to doing just parentheses, because they do have different concepts behind them and result in different answers.